Hey, hi ho, and howdy, everybody. My name is Shannon L. Shook, and the thing that you're watching is a thing. It's a different thing, but it's a thing nonetheless. It's Katawa Shoujo. So this is a thing. I'm trying to kind of get what I was just saying a second ago, because guess someone thought he hit record, but fun fact, he was already recording and accidentally quick stop recording when he's a fucking goddamn OBS. Anyway, but it's a goddamn OBS, but it's my fault. Anyway, this is a thing. So as you might have noticed, this is not Pokemon. This is not an episode of the review cap. This is a different game. So Katawa Shoujo is interesting because as you will no doubt be able to tell if you know anything about Katawa Shoujo, I've played a bit of this game before. By a bit of it, I mean I literally know everything that happens in it. It's been a while since I've messed around with it, but I have seen the entirety of the story that is there. Which is something I feel like I need to say right off the bat, because I don't want anyone going into this thing and like, oh, it's a brand new, fresh experience. It's completely new to him. Because it's just not. I've been through all this before. I know that I love the game because I've played it before. And what I haven't played, I've watched other people play. And this is a really good thing. And I will say this here and now, too. For any of you who don't care to listen to me ramble for a good probably 5 minutes or so, because I want to just preface all of what's happening here, I'll have like a timestamp of where you can go to if you'd like to skip me talking for no reason. So, you know, Katawa Shoujo is an interesting thing, because it's something that I've wanted to do for a while. And by a while, I mean like a year and a half before I ever started Doublehead. And that's because my brother and I, quite a while back, he started a channel thing of his own. I don't know if he's done anything with it since. I know he hasn't done this with it since. But he started a channel, and we thought it would be fucking hilarious if we just, you know, just played through the game together. I had already seen the whole thing, and I wanted to get his opinion on it. And he got really into it, too, which was kind of cool. I think we recorded, three or four episodes of it together. And I hope to God he still has it, because I want to say them, because they're fucking hilarious. Also, I say by far the dumbest thing that's ever come out of my mouth ever, and I recorded it, and I wasn't pretty unhappy about it, but, like, put a fucking damper on my day, but, you know, we played it together, and it was really great. We only ever got, again, like, 3 or 4 episodes into it, like, never made it out of Act 1 or anything like that, but, yeah, so it was something really cool that we could do together, and we just don't have time to do it together now, because he's, to make a long story short, is he is in a completely different city than I am. We don't have the ability to so easily interact with each other. In a perfect world, he would absolutely be here and we'd do it together, because that shit was fucking hilarious. Again, again, I will hope to try and get the videos that we made together. I realize I say that was a lot. God damn it. See, this is why I script all my shit. It's all scripted. Even the deaths in the randomizer and the Nuzlocke and stuff. It's predestined. It was planned. Anyway, this is something that I wanted to do since then. It was long before I ever got a channel, and then I started to get a channel. I'm like, that would be really fun to do someday. And I wanted to put it off for a couple reasons. One, like 12 people are subscribed to my channel. There's very, very few people who probably won't even sit down and watch it. If you happen to be one of those people who do, thank you. I don't have anything to give you except for hopefully a laugh and maybe just a nice dulcet reading. It's not going to be nice. Going through this is one of those things where, like, I don't know whether I'd be my funny, ridiculous, terrible self, or do I just play it really straight and cool. I don't know. Either way, we're just going to play it and hope that it turns out okay. But, yeah, the reason I put it off is because, one, as I said, I don't think anyone would even really see it. Two, as some of you may know, anyone who's been around on the channel a little bit will know that I'm a voice actor. Terrible voice actor, but a voice actor nonetheless. Recently, someone on one of the many sites that I... Admit me, I was only one. There was more earlier, but I haven't fucked around with any of those in a while. But on the site that I frequent as to get jobs and such, wanted to do a dub of the game. And I was really fucking into it, too, because I was like, a fucking chance to play the main character named Tsao, one of the fucking cool character. The game's fucking great. But I was really into it because it was one of the few voices that I've ever really been proud of. It's one of the roles I was really into because I do really care about the game and all that stuff like that. So the opportunity to do that was really cool, and everyone else seemed to agree. It was looking really, really good, like I was going to get it, and then I didn't. Like a day or two ago, and I was like, you know, that's no longer an excuse. Because I wanted to maybe not do that, because if I was just going to dub the game, what's the point of me just dicking around in the game myself? Fun fact, I'm not dubbing the game anymore. So, not that I was ever necessarily doing in the first place, but the possibility had been there. So yeah, since that didn't work, fuck it, I'm here. And the last reason, well, I guess that was the big one. But the reason I decided to do it is, again, I love the game, I've been wanting to do it forever. I've decided, screw it, Brayden I know is not going to be here anytime soon. As soon as I get the chance to have him here, though, he's absolutely playing this fucking game with me, and we're recording the shit out of it. But until then, it'll just be me. It's gonna be fucking ridiculous if we have two goddamn playthroughs, but whatever. So yeah, we will do it like that. And the biggest reason I decided to do it, this is way more than 5 minutes, but the main reason I decided to do it is... anyone who knows anything about Katawa Shoujo knows that it is the 5-year anniversary as of the day this video goes up. So, I didn't realize that was the case. I had no fucking idea. I just was dicking around on Reddit and saw that it was that way, so I was like, fuck it, you know? Fuck it. Fuck it. So, we're gonna play it. Again, I am familiar with the game. I've seen the entirety of the goddamn game, so there won't be anything necessarily surprising, unless it's something that I've forgotten, but, like, all the main shit I remember. As you can see, the ones that I've actually played through myself are, Emmy, Lily, and Rin. The others, I've watched, but not actually personally played through myself. So that'll be cool. But yeah, no. I'm all about it. I don't know if anyone else is, but I am. So let's go ahead, as soon as this music stops, start this game. A light breeze causes... Damn it, I've already fucked myself here. A light breeze causes the naked branches overhead to rattle like wooden wind chimes. This is a popular retreat for couples in the summer. The deciduous trees provide a beautiful green canopy, far out of sight from teachers and fellow students. But now, in late winter, it feels like I'm standing under a pile of kindling. I breathe into my cupped hands and rub them together furiously to prevent them from numbing in this cold. This is the problem, because this game is all reading, and anyone who knows me playing Pokemon knows I can't read for shit. Ah, thank God I got a big-ass thing of water. So forgive me when it's terrible. Or don't. Whatever. Just how long am I Just how long am I expected to wait out here anyway? I'm sure the note said 4 p.m. Ah, yes. The note. Slipped between the pages of my math book while I wasn't looking. As far as cliches go, I'm more of a fan of the letter in the locker, but at least this way it shows at least a bit of initiative. I'm a fucking writer and I can't read for shit. As I ponder the meaning of the note, the snowfall gradually thickens. The snowflakes silently falling from the white-painted sky are the only sign of time passing in this stagnant world. Their slow descent upon the frozen forest makes it seem like time is slowed to a crawl. The rustling of dry snow underfoot startles me, interrupting the quiet mood. Someone is approaching me from behind.
Hisao? You came?
I also like to establish the fact that I'm a dude with a relatively deep voice. Pretty deep. It's kind of down here a little bit. Ladies. A hesitating, barely audible question. However, I recognize the owner of that dainty voice instantly. I feel my heart skip a beat. It's a voice I've listened to hundreds of times, but never as more than an eavesdropper to a conversation. I turn to face this voice. The voice of my dream. The voice of my dreams! And my heart begins to race. Oomchik, 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 oomchik. Okay. Look at you! How you guys doing? Iwanako? I've never known how to pronounce her name. Someone tell me how to pronounce her name.
Iwanako?
I got a note telling me to wait here. It was yours? Damn it. Spent all afternoon trying to come up with a good line, and that was the result. Pathetic. Worthless. Terrible. Futile. Feeble. Sorry.
Yeah. I asked a friend to give you that note. I'm so glad you got it.
A shy, joyous smile that makes me so tense I couldn't move a single muscle even if I tried. I'm not paralyzed, but I seem to be struck by you. I got it. Fucking Christ. I made a conscious decision that I was not going to fucking sing in this series. That's happening. It's just going to happen. I'm sorry, but if you don't know me, I apparently can't go 5 minutes without singing a retarded song. My heart is pounding now, as if it were trying to burst out from my chest and claim the score for itself. Yeah, no, I saw the new Alien Covenant trailer too. See, the best part of a joke is when you stumble across the word covenant. So, here we are, out in the cold. Once again, the wind stirs up the branches, the cacophonous noise music to my ears. Iwanako finishes. See, your name fucked me up. I hope you feel bad about that. Iwanako I was doing so well! Flinches ever so softly against the gust of wind. As it passes, she rights herself, as if supported by some new confidence. Her eyes lock with mine, and she lazily twirls her long dark hair around her finger. All the while, the anxious beating of my heart grows louder. I can read. My throat is tight. I doubt I could even force a word out if I tried.
You see, I wanted to know if you'd go out with me. Maybe, kind of, you know, just like I kind of want the D. I'm just kind of here.
I stand there. Motionless, save for my pounding heart. I want to say something in reply, but my vocal cords feel like they've been stretched beyond the breaking point.
Sao?
I reach up to try and massage my throat. Get all up in there. Rub-a-dub-dub. But this only sends spikes of blinding pain along my arms.
Sao?
My whole body freezes, save for my eyes, which shoot open in terror, like it was the beginning of Resident Evil 5.
Hisao!
The beating of my chest suddenly stops, and I go weak at the knees. Yeah, no, my knees are bad too, man. Don't dislocate them 3 times in a row. The world around me, the canopy of bare branches, the dull winter sky. Iwanako, your name constantly fucks me up. Running towards me. All these fade to black. The last things I remember before slipping away are the sounds of every fucking time, of her screaming for help and the incessant clatter of the branches above.
Thank you.
It's been 4 months since my heart attack. Should probably click back on the fucking... In that whole time, I can probably count the number of times I've left this hospital room unsupervised on one hand. 4 months is a pretty long time when you're left alone with your thoughts. So I've had plenty of time to come to terms with my situation. Arrhythmia. A strange word. A foreign, alien one. One that you don't want to be in the same room with. A rare condition. It causes the heart to act erratically and occasionally beat way too fast. It can be fatal. Apparently, I've had it for a long time. They said it was a miracle that I was able to go on so long without anything happening. Is it really a miracle? I suppose it was supposed to make me feel better, more appreciative of my life. I didn't really do anything to cheer me up, though. Yes, I didn't. God damn it. My parents, I think, were hit harder by the news than I was. They practically had two hemorrhages apiece. I had already had a full day by then to digest everything. To them, it was all fresh. They were even willing to sell our house in order to pay for a cure. Of course, there isn't a cure. Because of the late discovery of this condition, I've had to stay at the hospital to recuperate from the treatments. When I was first admitted, I felt as if I was missed. For about a week, my room in the ward was full of flowers, balloons, and cards. But the visitors soon dwindled, and all the get-well gifts began trickling down to nothing shortly after. I realized that the only reason I'd gotten so many cards and flowers was because sending me their sympathy had been turned into a class project. Maybe some people were genuinely concerned, but I doubt it. Even in the beginning, I barely had visitors. By the end of the first month, only my parents came by on a regular basis. That bitch who I can't pronounce her fucking name was the last to stop visiting. See ya, bitch. After 6 weeks, I never saw her again. We never had all that much to talk about when she visited anyway. We didn't touch the subject that was between us on that snowy day ever again. The hospital? It's not really a place I'd like to live in. The doctors and nurses feel so impersonal and faceless. My fucking facial hair is fucking with me. I guess it's because they're all in a hurry and they've had a million other patients waiting for them, but it makes me feel uncomfortable. For the first month or so, I asked the head cardiologist every time I saw him for a rough estimate of when I'd be able to leave. He never answered anything in a straightforward way, but told me to wait and see if the treatment and surgeries worked. So, I idly observed the scar that those surgeries that had left on my chest slowly changed its appearance over time, thinking of it as some kind of omen. I still think... You don't think, Sal. You're an anime protagonist. I still ask the head cardiologist about leaving, but my expectations are low enough now that I'm not disappointed anymore when I don't get a reply. The way he shuffles around the answer shows that there's at least some hope. At some point, I stopped watching TV. I don't know why, I just kind of did. They stopped showing reruns of Night Court, and I got really, really sad. And Lord knows they don't show Ruby. Maybe it was the wrong kind of escapism for my situation, or it was those other two things. I started reading instead. There was a small library at the hospital, although it was more like a storeroom for books. I began working my way through it, one small stack at a time. After consuming them, I would go back for more. I found I liked reading, and I think I even became a bit addicted. I started feeling naked without a book in my hands. You do you, boo. But I loved the stories. That was what my life was like. The days became increasingly harder to distinguish from each other, differing only by the book I was reading and the weather outside. It felt like time blurred into some kind of gooey mass I was trapped inside, instead of moving within. A week could go by without me really noticing it. Sometimes I'd pause in realization that I didn't know what day of the week it was. But other times, all the things that surrounded me would painfully crash into my consciousness through the barrier of nonchalance I'd set up for myself. The pages of my book would start to feel sharp and burning hot, and the heaviness in my chest would become so hard to bear that I had to put the book aside and just lay down for a while, looking at the ceiling as if I was going to cry. I know this feeling. That was me in high school. But what happened... But, damn it. But that happened only rarely. And I couldn't even cry. I could. It was... It's a skill. It's a lost art form, to be honest. Sometimes you just gots to... Today, the doctor comes in and gives me a smile. He seems half excited, but not very. It's like he's trying to make an effort to be happy on my behalf. That's kind of his job. You ungrateful little bastard. My parents are here. It's been a few days since I've last seen them. Both of them are even sort of dressed up. Is this supposed to be kind of some kind of special occasion? It's not a party. Ain't no fucking little what are the fucking things that have the like the and the thing whatever. There's this ritual the head cardiologist has. He takes his time sorting his papers, then setting them aside as if to make a point of the pointlessness of what he just did. Then he casually sits down on the edge of the bed next to mine. He looks me in the eyes for a moment. He looked at me, and I looked at him, and he looked back at me, and I looked back at him.
Hello, Ashao. How are you doing today?
I don't answer him, but I smile a little back.
I believe that you can go home. Your heart's a bit stronger now, and with some precautions, you should be totally fine. Probably. Maybe. We have all your medication sorted out. I'll give your father the prescriptions.
The doctor hands a sheet of paper to my dad. His expression turns wooden as he reads it quickly. So many. And he's British. All right. I take it from his hand and take a look at myself, feeling numb. And take a look at myself, feeling numb. How am I supposed to react to this? I am robot. The absurdly long list of medications staring back at me from the paper seems insurmountable. They all blend together in a sea of letters. This is insane. Side effects, adverse effects, contraindications, and dosages are listed line after line with cold precision. Can we talk about the fact that when I first saw that, I had to look that fucking word up because I didn't know what was going on. I still don't know. I need water. My throat hurts. I tried to read them, but it's so futile. I can't understand any of it. Attempting to only makes me feel sicker. All this? For the rest of my life? Every day? What's this bullshit?
I'm afraid that it's the best we can do at this point. However, new medications are always being developed, so I wouldn't be surprised to see that list fade over the years. Like, many, many... You're going to have a horrific life, good sir.
Years? What kind of confidence booster is that? I'd have felt better if you hadn't sent anything at all.
Also, I've spoken with your parents, and we believe it would be best if you didn't return to your old school. So you will not be going home like I literally just said that you could. I am an asshole.
What?
Please, calm down, sir. Listen to what the doctor has to say.
And now he's like Scottish. What? Calm down? The way he says it tells me he knew full well that I wouldn't like it. Am I going to be homeschooled? Whatever of my concern shows, it's completely ignored.
We all understand that your education is paramount. However, I don't think that it's wise for you to be without supervision. At all times. In the bathroom, on the toilet, in a lady. At least not until we are sure that your medication is suitable. So, I've spoken to your parents about a transfer. Yeah, it's great. You're going to go over there, and it is a school called Yamaku Academy that specializes in dealing with disabled students. You know, like, you know, people who have been hit with the move disable from the Pokemans. I understand you have a series based on it. Shameless plug.
Disabled? What? Am I...
It has a 24-hour nursing staff. It's only like a few minutes from a highly regarded general hospital. The majority of students live on the campus. It's so much sex happens there all the time. Left and right. Right and left. Up and down. Back and forth. Think of it as a boarding school of sorts. It is designed to give students a degree of independence while keeping help nearby.
Independence? It's a school for disabled kids. Don't try to disguise that fact. If it was really that free, there wouldn't be a 24-hour nursing staff, and you wouldn't make a hospital being nearby a selling point.
Of course, that's only if you want to go. But your mother and I aren't really able to homeschool you.
We went out there and had a look a couple of weeks back. I think you'd like it.
Looks as if I don't really have a choice.
Compared to the other heart problems, people with your condition usually tend to live long lives. Sometimes. Maybe. You'll need a job one day, and this is a great opportunity to learn English. Unlike me.
This isn't an opportunity. Don't call it an opportunity. Don't call it a goddamned opportunity.
Well, you should be excited at the chance to go back to school. I remember you wanted to return to school. And while it's not the same, but that's not an excuse.
A special school, that's an insult. My fucking voice. That's what I want to say. It's a step down. Don't think too fucking high and mighty of yourself, you bastard.
It's not what you think. All of the students there are pretty active in their own sort of way, except for the, like, people who are missing all of the body parts.
Oh, no. It's all bad.
It's geared towards students that can still get around and learn, but just need a little help in one way or another.
Fuck, that was the dad, wasn't it? God damn it, I don't even... Fuck.
Your father's right, even though he sounds exactly like me. Maybe that's why I think he's right. He is me. I am your father. Asao, I am your father. And many of the graduates of the school have gone on to do amazing things, like... A person doesn't have to be held back by their disability. One of my colleagues in another hospital's a graduate. There was what I was looking for.
I don't care. A person doesn't have to be held back by their disability? That's what a disability is. I really hate that something so important was decided for me. But what can I do about it? A normal life is out of the question now. It's funny. I'd always thought my life was actually kind of boring, but now I miss it. I want to protest, but I blame this lack of reaction on shock or fatigue. I could easily yell out something now, but something about how I could go on to school anyway, but no. I don't say anything. The fact is that I know it's futile. I look around the room, feeling very tired of all this. The hospital, doctors, my condition, everything. The music is gone, and that means you just have to listen to my voice. May God have mercy on your soul. I don't see anything that would make me feel any different. There really isn't a choice. I know this, but the thought of going to a disabled school, what are those even like? As much as I try to put a positive spin on this, it's very difficult. But let me try. A clean slate isn't a bad thing. That's all I can think of to get me through this. At least I still have something. Even if it's a special school, it's something. It's a fresh start, and my life isn't over. It would be a mistake to just resign myself to thinking that. At the very least, I'll try to see what my new life will look like.